Well, I had gone to the Philippines on my first trip, and then I went to Guatemala, and then I went to India. And Michael Carell, he was the president at that time for years, and he had seen this change in me, this transformation in me. And we had a great board of directors, and there was a doctor who was the heir apparent to take over the leadership of CMM upon Michael's passing. But Michael, just about 60 days before he passed away, he said he was making an executive decision that the Lord clearly spoke to him that I was the man to be prudent and prepared to take over CMM. And so it was like an executive decision. The board would never have voted on me or approved me. So it was a God thing. But he saw how the Lord had touched me, and the other board members had seen also. And I was just hungering for more of the Lord. And so God gave me favor, still does, and it was God's mercy and grace that saw me take over the position. And during the prayer time, really, for several weeks, when Michael had asked me to take over the leadership position, I was really asking the Lord and seeking the Lord if I should do that, because my background had been in business, and the Lord had really blessed us in business. And I remember one time the Lord speaking really clearly to me. He said, if with my background in business to view CMM as a shell corporation, and if I was obedient to the Holy Spirit, that He would breathe upon it and bring resurrection power into CMM at that time. And the family members had wanted to shut CMM down. And so you had the family going on, you had the board with its different wishes and things like that. But I made a commitment to Michael to take care of those people. And he went over many of specific challenges and charges with me in loyalty with the missionaries and really adopting them as family, and that it's a lifetime commitment with them of caring for them and handling donor relations and supporting them. And you know, I thought I was coming on to CMM as an administrator, and I've learned since then through trials and experience and tribulations that really God called me there as the intercessor for these missionaries. So I had met first Helen Carell, and then I met her son Michael, who was a good friend of mine. And he passed away at the age of 52 in 1998 from Lou Gehrig's disease. And he had asked me to go to a Bible school graduation in the Philippines, where we have Carell Missionary Ministries Philippines, in March of 1998. So that was my first real trip. I had written down goals in 1995, prayers of being able to go on short-term mission trip and some other things. And it was amazing how the Lord answered prayers during those years. He still does, and we've seen a lot of answered prayers. But I went on that mission trip to the far north of the Philippines and spoke at the Bible school graduation. And I had told Michael, I said, well, who am I? You know, I've not been to Bible school, I'm not ordained. And he said, God is looking for available hearts to go. And that always stuck with me. And so we shared that with people to encourage them to experience the beauty of God's holiness in different cultures through being available to go and going out by faith, getting out of our comfort zones and seeing what the Lord will do when we enter the faith realm. So I went on that trip, and I came back from that trip just like a changed person. That really messed me up in a really good way, in a beautiful way. And I remember drinking a glass of ice water and just weeping of like, God, who are we to be so blessed? And my wife picked me up at the airport up in Virginia, and I said, wow, the roads are so smooth, you know. And I had been saved before, but really that first encounter with the Lord overseas really awoken every cell in my being to the Lord. So it really was like being reborn or born again in a whole new way that really awakened me to the love of God for His people.